Hello everyone, I am Ajay Kumar. I am here to present my topic on corrosion in chemistry. Corrosion. Let's move on to the topic. Introduction of corrosion. Corrosion is a process of formation of the compound of pure metal by the chemical reaction between metallic surface and its environment. It's an oxidation process. It causes loss of metal, hence disintegration of a metal by its surrounding chemicals. Through a chemical reaction on the surface of the metal is called corrosion. Example, formation of rust on the surface of iron, formation of green film on the surface of copper. The responsible factors for the corrosion of a metal are metal itself, the environmental chemicals, temperature and the design. Types of corrosion. My topic on the types of corrosion is differential aeration corrosion. We will go on to the waterline corrosion. Differential aeration corrosion. This type of corrosion takes place when metal is unevenly exposed to different oxygen or air concentrations. The part which is exposed to less oxygen undergoes corrosion. At anode, less O2 concentration, which will result in metal forming in metal ions, releasing electrons. At cathode, more O2 concentration, which react with water and absorbs those electrons and forms 2 moles of hydroxide ions. Examples are drop corrosion. It takes place when a drop of electrolyte is in contact with the metal surface. The metal surface covered by is in contact with lesser amount of air than the uncovered metal surface. Thus, metal covered by the drop becomes anodic and corroded, whereas the uncovered metal surface becomes cathodic. Waterline corrosion. Some examples. Why iron tank corrodes just beneath the waterline? A pure metal rod half immersed vertically in water starts corroding at the bottom. Explain why. Why does part of nail inside the wood undergoes corrosion easily than the outer side? Let's see in detail. Waterline corrosion. Waterline corrosion, a case of differential aeration corrosion, more prevalent in cases such as ocean going ships, water storage steel tanks, etc., in which a portion of the metal is always under water. The waterline corrosion takes place due to the formation of differential oxygen concentration cells. The part of the metal below the water line is exposed only to dissolved oxygen, while the part above the water is exposed to higher oxygen concentration of the atmosphere. Thus, part of the metal below the water acts as anode and undergoes corrosion, and part above the waterline is free from corrosion. A distinct brown line is formed just below the waterline due to deposition. Here are some photos of waterline corrosion. Waterline corrosion occurs mainly because of differential in oxygen concentration in atmosphere and water. This happens because the portion of the substrate exposed to higher amounts of oxygen, that means concentration of oxygen, becomes as cathode, and the portion in less oxygen area, which is underwater, acts as anode. This creation of anode and cathode allows oxidation to occur. This ultimately causes the area of the substrate submerged in water to become oxidized and corrode finally. Waterline corrosion is a concern in several different industries. Tanks that are used to store liquids such as water are often prone to waterline corrosion. Marine structures can also fall victim to waterline corrosion. This can lead to a complete structural failure. Ships that are left in the water for extended periods of time can be at risk of waterline corrosion as well. Waterline corrosion can be combated by several different methods. One way is to coat the material being placed in the water. The coating keeps oxygen exposure across the substrate to a uniform amount and to a minimum. Another method is to use materials that are not as prone to oxidation as steel. Stainless steels and aluminium may be better alternatives to deter waterline corrosion. Here are some underlying pipes which were corroded by waterline corrosion. Corrosion control methods. Methods of corrosion control. These are the most needed methods to prevent corrosion, which may result in huge loss. Let's see some of the methods of corrosion control. Surface coatings, proper designing, use of pure metal, using metal alloys, modifying the environment, use of inhibitors, cathodic protection. Surface coating. The common and oldest method of protection of a metal from its surroundings is by surface coatings. These may be metallic coatings or organic coatings. The coated metal isolates the metal from its corroding environment. And finally, we have ended our topic. And thank you.